COVID concerts are both controversial and complicated to execute safely in these unprecedented times. While many artists have put their performances on pause, some headliners like Metallica, Blake Shelton, Garth Brooks, and most recently country singer Kane Brown are packing in drive-in theaters for virtual taped events. This while the demand and backlash for live events rages on. Recently in Sacramento, nearly 11,000 music fans, many maskless, gathered for a Christian concert at the end of the summer, igniting a firestorm over the safety of such large-scale events. So, is there a way to congregate and concert more safely? Scientists are trying to find out by putting on their own COVID concert. Researchers in Germany staged a fake show with a real band and 1,500 volunteers. They called it Restart 19, and under varied controls, they hoped to determine the elements that pose the greatest risk for COVID-19 transmission in this setting. Digital trackers, hand disinfectant laced with fluorescent dye, and fog machines were used in the simulation. The hope is this will bring in reliable data to help create safety measures for live events around the world. Will it work?
Back with us again is top infectious disease specialist, Dr. Brad Spellberg. Welcome back, Brad. How are you?
I'm very well, Dr. Ian. How are you?
Good, thanks. Hey, listen, man, fluorescent hand sanitizer, fog machines. I mean, this sounds like a rave rather than science. Did this study work?
Well, you know, we don't have the results yet, but the design of the study does not make it clear to me that we're really going to understand the safety of these events. They were trying to get 4,000 volunteers. They ended up only getting 1,500, which is already a little bit of a red flag. And they were all tested for COVID and had temperature checks at the door before they went in the venue. And as you mentioned, they had fluorescent dye put on their hands, the goal of which then was going to see, you know, how far would they spread that dye around the facility and onto their own body. And they did it under three circumstances, which was sort of pre-COVID, just do what you want, sort of a loose set of social distancing, and then a really strict set of social distancing to see if social distancing measures would actually reduce spread.
And when they set up this study, the idea was, just to be clear, they're not infecting people with COVID. They use a dye to trace it to kind of simulate if it was COVID. We're living in uncertain times. It's tough to keep up with the latest medical headlines.
About the market, panicked about COVID.
And how do those headlines impact you and your family?
100,000 people shot.
On season 13 of The Doctors, we want to empower you physically.
If I met them at dance, they would meet me at medicine.
Man, I love that. Emotionally.
If I can change my thoughts, I can change my feelings.
And medically.
He doesn't have his mask up, which is not a good thing.
This is the $1 million question, maybe the $1 trillion question. This is so critical for people to hear. We're giving you the inside track on health and wellness so that you can get back to the life you deserve. It's time to take back your power. The Doctors, now more than ever. Premieres September 21st.